Good afternoon, class 7s. Today we are going to do a few operations on the algebraic expressions. Everybody open your maths book to page 94. We are going to do, let's do ourselves 6.4. Come to sum number 1, part 1. Here we are going to add the given two algebraic expressions. So the first algebraic expression is minus 5x plus 3y, and the second algebraic expression is 18x minus 15y. So it is given in brackets. So our first work is to open the brackets. So I've opened the bracket and I've written minus 5x plus 3y, and in the next one also you have positive sign before this bracket. Can you see this plus sign? This plus sign is present before the bracket. So in that case, when positive sign is present before the bracket, in case of addition, that means the signs of the terms present inside the bracket will remain the same as it is. Just like 18x, it has positive sign, so it will become plus 18x, it will remain as plus 18x, and this one was minus 15y, so it remained as minus 15y. Now in the third step, what we will do is we are going to separate the like and unlike terms together. So in yesterday's class I have mentioned you about the like and unlike terms. What are called like terms and unlike terms? That is, a term having the same type of variable attached with it, that is called the like term. So here in the second line we can see that minus 5x and 18x are the two like terms. So we have written this minus 5x plus 18x together, and here in the next line we have plus 3y minus 15y. So all the y terms, means the term associated with y, I have written together. So I've written like this, plus 3y minus 15y. Now we are going to do the addition. Now this, we have minus 5x plus 18x. So this plus 18x, it is obviously greater than minus 5x, means it is greater than 5x. So as you do in case of whole numbers or in case of arithmetic addition, in the same way you are going to do the addition. That is actually 18x minus 18x minus 5x. So 18x minus 5x means 13x, and 3y minus 15y. So 15y is greater than 3y. So we will put the sign of the greater number, that is a greater variable. I have put the sign, that is minus 12y. Why? Because 15 minus 3 is 12. So it will be, so therefore we will get 15y minus 3y, that is 12y. So finally we are getting 13x minus 12y. Now come to the next sum, that is part 2. Here we have 7a minus 8b plus 2c plus 2a plus 3b minus d. So here also the step will remain the same. You have positive sign, that is a plus sign before the bracket. In the first step you are going to open the brackets, and the signs of the terms inside the bracket will remain the same as it is. This 2a will remain as plus 2a, this plus 3b will remain as plus 3b, and minus d will remain as minus d. Now our next work is to segregate or separate all the like terms together. Means all the terms associated with a, you have 7a and plus 2a over here. So 7a plus 2a, and all the terms associated with b, minus 8b plus 3b. And now you have the terms with c, only one term is present with c, having c, that is plus 2c and minus d, only d term, only one term is there. So now in the next step what you will do is 7a plus 2a is 9a. As you know, 7 plus 2 is 9, So 7a plus 2a will be 9a, and minus 8b plus 3b means minus 5b, because you know that minus 8 plus 3 is minus 5. So it will remain as minus 5, and this b will this remain, means minus 8b plus 3b will become minus 5b plus 3c, and we have minus d. So finally we are getting the answer as 9a minus 5b plus 2c minus d. Now come to sum number 2, part 1. Here we will have to do the subtraction. So for doing the subtraction, the two terms we will write like the first term minus the second term. So now listen carefully that whenever there is negative sign outside the bracket, the signs of the terms inside the bracket becomes positive when you open the bracket. That means you have minus of minus 7, you have minus 7 inside the bracket, so that will become plus 7 when it comes outside the bracket. You have minus m inside the bracket, it will become plus m when it comes outside the bracket. You have plus n inside the bracket, it will become minus n when it comes out of the bracket. So what is the reason behind this changing of the sign? The changing of the sign is taking place, the change of the sign is taking place because you have negative sign outside the bracket. So actually this minus into minus is becoming plus, so you have plus mn, the signs are getting multiplied. So minus into minus is plus m, and minus into plus is minus. That is why we are getting minus n. Now in the next step we will, in this step you can see that this plus n and minus n is getting cancelled, just like plus 1 minus 1 is 0. So thereby in this same way this plus n and minus n is also getting cancelled, and you have this 4mn plus mn, that is 5mn. All the like terms you are adding together, 4mn plus mn, that is 5mn, and m plus m, you are having 2m. You are getting the final answer as 5mn plus 2m. Now part 2, you have p square plus q square minus pq plus p square q minus 2q square plus 3p square minus qp plus pq square. Here also, as I said in the first step, what you will do is you are going to open the brackets, and for the second algebraic expression, this is the second algebraic expression, and for the given second algebraic expression, what you will do is you are going to open the bracket and change the signs of the terms present inside the bracket. Why? Because you have a minus sign present outside the bracket. So after changing the terms, and you can see this minus pq and plus pq, that is a qp and pq means the same, it is getting cancelled, and you are having minus p square q means minus 2pq p square, that is 2 negative p square are terms are there, that is minus p square, it is giving minus 2 p square, and minus q square is already here, that is plus q square, minus 2 q square, you are getting minus q square, and this p q square will already remain, and this p q means that this p square q will already remain, and this p q square also will remain. So this one is your final answer. So while doing these operations, be careful about the terms, that you don't miss out any term. Now come to page number 94. We are going to do let's work out 6.2. Here in sum number 1, you have to do the simple additions like 5x plus 3x. You have 8x. Why? Because 5 plus 3 is 8, and this x will come in common, that is it will become 8x. 9y minus 3y is 6y, because 9 minus 3 is 6, and this y will come in common. Here also minus 4y plus 7y equals to minus 4 plus 7, that is 7 minus 4 you have 3y. And minus 10x minus 2x means both are negative, so ultimately we will have to add it. Means minus sign will remain and you will have to do the addition operation, that is 10 plus 2, 12x. Number 5, you have 3a plus 4a minus 2a. Then this 3a plus 4a means 7a. 7a minus 2a means 5a. Come to sum number 6. Minus 7x minus 2x plus 5x. So first, this from this minus 7x and minus 2x, we got minus 9x because this negative sign comes into common and we are going to do plus. Means add these two. 7x plus 2x, that is minus 9x plus 5x. That is, we are going to put the sign of the greater variable. Obviously, 9x is bigger than 5x as 9 is greater than 5. So we are going to put the sign of the bigger variable, that is 9x, that becomes minus, and 9 minus 5 is 4. So we have minus 4x as the answer. Come to the next sum, that is, we have 6p minus 2p plus 3p, which is equals to, now 6p plus 3p you will have to do together. 6p plus 3p is 9p. And 9p minus 2p means 7p. Next, 4x square minus 2x square minus 3x square plus 6 square. Now, you will have to write all the terms having the positive sign together. That means here you have 4x square and here you have x square. So, 4x square and x square means 5x square. And all the negative signs you will have to write together, that is minus 2x square and minus 3x square. Then after the computation we have minus 5x square. So 5x square minus 5x square equals to 0, as you know that 5 minus 5 is 0. So 5x square minus 5x square also means 0. Number 9, 5a square b minus 2a square b minus 3a square b plus 8a square b. Here also you are going to write all the terms having the positive sign together, as I have written. 5a square b and 8a square b are written together, and 2a square b and minus 2a square b and minus 3a square b are written together. So 13a square b, after addition of 5a square b and 8a square b, I have got 13a square b. Means why? Because 8 plus 5, that is 13. So a square b will remain, this variable term will remain, and you have from minus 2a square b and minus 3a square b, you have minus 5a square b. So now 13 minus 5 is 8. So we have the answer as 8a square b. Now come to number 10. You have 3x square minus 6x square minus 9x square. Minus 2x square minus x square plus 6x square. So 3x square, all the terms having the positive sign, I have told you to write together. That is a 3x square plus 6x square, we have got 9x square. And all the terms having the negative signs, I have written together. And after addition means 6 plus 2 plus 1, that is 9x square. 9x square plus 9x square, 9x square minus 9x square, we have 0. Why? Because this 9 minus sign, we have 0. So today, for today, that's all. Thank you, children.